I appreciate members of the media making the effort to be here on a Sunday afternoon. This morning I met with Coach Butch Jones to discuss the future of the football program, and I informed him of my decision that he stepped down as the University of Tennessee's head football coach. Transitions like this are never easy for anyone involved, and I'm grateful for the way Coach Jones, Barb, Alex, Adam, and Andrew have poured their hearts and souls into this community and into the improvement of our football program over the past 5 years. I know that Coach Jones will be successful as he moves forward in his career, and I know that Tennessee fans join me in thanking the entire Jones family for their service and dedication to this community and to the University of Tennessee. Coach Brady Hoke will serve as interim head coach through the remainder of the season, and as always, I am confident that the Vol Nation will stick together, rally around this team, and support our student athletes. We will begin an exhaustive search for a person of the highest integrity and character, with the skills and vision to propel Tennessee to championships. This is an extraordinarily special place with unique opportunities and a tradition of excellence. This coaching search will be my sole focus, and I will be in regular contact with Chancellor Davenport. I want to emphasize my commitment to hiring the best coach in Tennessee. In light of what Tom said earlier, I encourage you to ask your questions today, as I do not plan to comment on the search publicly until we're prepared to introduce our new head coach. Questions?
Mark?
John Mark Packer, WBLT. When you were hired as the athletic director, there were a number of requirements essentially in your background and your resume for you to get the job. What kind of requirements do you have in mind for the next head coach at UT?
Thank you, Mark. Certainly all of our coaches, all of our searches will start with integrity and a commitment to doing things the right way. And if you look at our program and the areas of particular improvement of our program under Coach Jones' leadership, and you see the APR and the involvement of our student athletes in our community and all those things, those are certainly prerequisites. Certainly we expect our coach to have the dynamics that would enable him to lead us to where we know Tennessee can and should, Tennessee football can and should be. Our coach needs to know what that looks like.
Rick Rizzolo. Awesome.
Rick Rizzolo, Lake News. And John, first and foremost, was this decision made with regards to the timing with recruiting and the early signing day coming up, number one, and number two, comment maybe on reports of which may be swaying recruits away from Tennessee and your fear of things like that possibly happening?
Rick, let's go to you. The first question. Any decisions we make affect student athletes, and they affect our staff, and they obviously affect our university, and we'll always make the decisions at the time we make them with those interests in mind and the best for our student athletes. As to your second question, I find that kind of stuff, speculative stuff, silly, and I trust Butch Jones and his character.
Coach Jimmy, then we'll do Kirsten and Austin.
He's done a couple of things. One, in regard to the timing, why now as opposed to maybe a couple of weeks or after Vanderbilt? And secondly, was Butch relieved for any cause?
The second question, Coach Jones was not relieved for cause. He was relieved without cause. And Tom has copies of the letter or contract with those terms that you can have on your way out today. As far as the timing, again, the decisions we make should always be made with the best interests of our student athletes in mind. And I believed as we went throughout the season, even though there were moments when of frustration, there were also moments of optimism. And I wanted to give our coaching staff and our student athletes the best possible chance to be successful. And I believed that best possible chance to be successful and win the games was under Coach Jones' leadership.
Kirsten?
John, Kirsten, yourself at WBIR. I was just wondering, as far as how things played out, was Butch given the opportunity to coach the last two games of the season?
Coach Jones and I met this morning and discussed the situation and my view about where we were as a program. We came to a mutual decision about the last couple of games. I believe it's the right decision for all concerned.
Awesome.
John, also Price, Fall Quest.com.
recruiting is so important. The Vanderbilt weekend was supposed to be a big visit weekend. How do you handle that? And what's your message to prospective guys that will either open back up their commitment, you know, maybe give you time to get somebody hired before making a final decision?
Sure. Well, certainly recruiting is the lifeblood of what we do, attracting great student-athletes to the University of Tennessee. All the intangibles about what makes our program and this university, the city of Knoxville, the history and tradition of Neyland Stadium, the facilities, the academic support, the high graduation rates, all those things are things that will continue to be attractive to student-athletes at the University of Tennessee. I would also say that upstairs on the fourth floor of this building, we have some great people, men and women, who have worked very hard to rebuild the Tennessee football program and have moved the Tennessee football program forward. Those men and women that came to work this morning, some of them haven't been home still because they went right from the meetings that they had with Coach Jones and then with me, right back into their work, be that recruiting stuff or game planning for the LSU game, you name it. And so I just have tremendous respect and appreciation for those people up on the fourth floor. And you know, many of them left this morning and their spouses and children didn't know what was coming. And they haven't been home to see their spouses and children because they're focused and dedicated to our student athletes and to our program and to doing their jobs. And so that's our whole focus right now.
Steve and then Brent.
Regarding the Associated Press, just regarding that early signing period, just the first year with it, how much did that impact your decision? How much tougher did it make the decision on when to do this, and how does it affect your timeline for finding a successor?
Well, Steve, that's a very good question. You know, the early signing period being December 20th through December 22nd is new and it's uncharted territory for all of us to some extent. Ultimately, we have to make the decision we believe is the best interest of the student-athletes we have at the University of Tennessee right now, the student-athletes who are approaching graduation, some of whom are playing their last two games in Neyland Stadium over the next couple days, while we also look at the long-term future of our program. So it certainly is a variable that's new, but the core values and how we make decisions remain the same.
John, Brent Hubbs. Couple of things. One, who will you lean to, or will you have a committee? You said it would be your sole job. Will you lean on anybody? Will you have a committee? Secondly, will you hire a search firm to help you through this process?
So I'm very fortunate and blessed. We've got a great team internally throughout the department that love and serve the University of Tennessee for many years. So while we have this particular element, which is my sole focus, which is this search, we also have a lot of other stuff going on in terms of other teams competing. We had two teams compete today, one at home and one on the road. We've got a soccer team in the NCAA playoffs in the next round next week. We've got a big football game next weekend. We got a lot of work to do, and so I'll lean on our entire staff to continue to carry forward the day-to-day operations of the athletics program. I consider myself very blessed. I've been able to develop really good relationships across intercollegiate athletics. And I'll rely on some of those relationships as well as some folks in and around this community.
Search firm?
No.
No search firm?
Not this time.
Nathaniel and then Charlie.
Hey, John, Nathaniel Rutherford from Walkie Top Insider here. What made you decide to choose Brady Hoke as the interim head coach for the football program?
Nathan, thank you for asking that question. You know, certainly there are nine full-time coaches and then Coach Stripling, you know, who could have chosen. Brady Hoke is a three-time conference coach of the year, three different conferences, has won at the highest level, was a very appropriate choice. I also would commend Brady, Coach Hoke. We had him into the office immediately after my discussion with Coach Jones, and I gave him the opportunity to serve as interim coach. And what he said was he got into this for student-athletes, and we got student-athletes who were getting ready to play their last two regular season ball games of the year. That was his focus. So I appreciate his leadership and selflessness at this time.
Hey, John, just regarding the report about former BFL coordinator Anthony Davis informing you that you felt you've been treated with hostility by Coach Jones, just wondering if you care to comment about that.
We wish Anton the best that those in his future pursuits. Those reports had nothing to do with this decision.
Jimmy Hounds at WNMO Radio. Do you feel like you need to hire somebody that has had head coaching experience?
J- Jimmy, I appreciate the question. We need to hire the best coach for the University of Tennessee. There's lots of different experiences out there that are relevant to our environment. Certainly, we need to hire someone who understands the magnitude that comes along with this job and the opportunities and the responsibility that come along with being the head football coach at the University of Tennessee.
Jesse Simon from BallQuest.com. John, with the buyout and the rest of the staff, financial commitment that will have to be paid to the rest of this staff, what sort of financial or money are we talking about here with the search going forward?
So I believe, again, as it relates to Coach Jones specifically, that's somewhere in the $8.5 million range, and Zach and Tom have that information for you. Overall, all of our assistant coaches are on two-year contracts, and so altogether it's in the $13 million range. That is mitigated, of course, as it's quite possible that some would be retained on our next staff or that they would find jobs elsewhere if they're not retained on the next staff. So we understand that's a significant amount of money and a significant investment, and don't take that lightly. On the other side, we're fortunate that we have the ability to manage that without impacting our day-to-day operations, our ability to attract the next coach, or our ability to keep marching forward with some of the projects we've talked about recently.
Mark, and then Rob.
John Markheimer again. In this hiring process, will money be an issue to get the top candidate that you want? And B, as an athletic director, fundamentally you are tied with the head football coach. How much pressure do you feel, having just gotten here, that your signature hire is right in front of you?
Well, Mark, thank you for the first question in terms of our money. We could always use some more around here, but we know that we have the resources to make the right decision to select the next leader of our football program. In terms of me, I'm really superfluous in terms of Tide and legacies and all that kind of stuff. I understand the enormous responsibility that goes along with leading a process like this. I understand what's at stake.
Bob Lewis, BallQuest.com. John, I know you weren't here when Bush was hired, but the perception was that you came into a major rebuilding job. What's your perception of what the next guy is coming into? Do you feel like he's further along and set up the game fairly quickly?
Sure, Rob. Well, there's a number of different elements. We all know that our conference continues to become even more competitive than it's always been, despite ideas that it's down or not down or whatever. That's an ongoing level of competitiveness really across the game. We're fortunate that Coach Jones and his staff changed the culture from an academic perspective. I would tell you that our Thornton Center staff and people on campus appreciate the fact that this staff, this outgoing staff, has made our academic excellence and academic achievement an expectation for our student athletes. And we sit here with the highest graduation rate and APR scores in our history in football. So those things make it better for the next staff. That was something that Coach Jones had to overcome right away. We also have an extraordinary facility, the Anderson Training Center, which I suppose was still under completion or under construction, or maybe just being finished when Coach Jones arrived. The city of Knoxville has continued to blossom. Our university community has continued to become better and better in terms of the aesthetics and the beauty of our campus and the quality facilities academically and athletically across our campus. The academic reputation of our university has continued to grow. There are a lot of great things about this university, not to mention 100,000 seat stadium with passionate fans.
Emily Van Austin.
Emily Proud, WAT. I'm just wondering, have you or do you plan to speak to the team? If so, what's your message to those guys?
And Emily, I did speak to the team earlier today. Coach Jones spoke to the team first, and then I followed. I thank them for their continued commitment to doing the right things, focusing on LSU and focusing on the game after that. The fact we've got exams coming up, continue doing the right thing. I was very pleased. Obviously, they respect and appreciate our outgoing head coach, but they're also committed to being Tennessee Volunteers and doing things the right way.
John Austin Price again. How much were you relying on Coach Fulmer? I know it was important to get back in the fold when you took this job over. And then two, you honored the 97 national or the SEC champions this weekend.
how much during this time of transition is that to kind of need to have this kind of uniting of an old team?
Well, thank you, Austin. Certainly, Coach Fulmer is an extraordinary resource for us in lots of ways, and I do regularly talk to him about various aspects of the program. I did call him this morning after I met with Coach Jones because I wanted him to be aware of where we were. We'll continue to consider him a great resource. We have a number of great resources around here. I sent a note out earlier this afternoon to our VFL football alumni. The opportunity we have with the championship team reuniting this weekend is one to again remind us all of our kind of what it looks like for the University of Tennessee, what it's supposed to look like. And at the same time, we have young men who have played their hearts out all year long. And they played with extraordinary circumstances and injuries and then, speculation and all that kind of stuff, and they've continued to bring it every game. I believe that all of our former players understand that more than anyone. And I know that our former players and our fans will rally behind our team this weekend and then again against Vanderbilt the following weekend.
Rick and then Jimmy.
Over Russo locally again. John, you've got a good relationship with Coach, no doubt. From a personal standpoint, how difficult was this decision? I venture to say, coming in your first season as athletics director, probably the last thing you expected to do or want to do.
Rick, I have a tremendous respect for Coach Jones and for Barb. And as I said earlier, they poured everything in to making our program better, and our program is better than it was when they arrived 5 years ago. These are difficult things. They're hard things. I couldn't be more proud of the way that as we've continued to battle adversity over the last 5 or 6 weeks, how Coach Jones has stuck to his values. We had to suspend a couple really important players a few weeks ago before we played at Kentucky. What he said when we talked about that was, I'm not compromising our values. And my admiration for him has only grown in this process. And so he was an absolute professional. We talked this morning. He cares about his team. He cares about his coaching staff. And he cares about the University of Tennessee.
Jimmy Hines again. John, when you met with Coach Jones this morning, what was his reaction when you informed him? And did he try to talk you out of your decision?
Jimmy, we had a very professional and appropriate conversation and continued to have interactions over the next several hours as we work through the logistics. He cares about our student athletes, and he cares about our coaches, and he cares about this university.
Steve?
Dan, question to John. We're back here. I want to be clear. Do you have any intention of using a short term?
I've not at this time.
Been very complimentary of those groups today. You're very complimentary of the work you've done before this season. From your perspective, what caused this to have to happen? What that was?
Well, we're standing here right now because we haven't won enough.
John, just with all the rumors kind of circulating out there, how do you kind of navigate a coaching search through all that? John Gruden's name has been thrown out there a bunch. Is there anything you can say to Tennessee fans about John Gruden and just – does the timeline with December 20th and the recruiting calendar, does that impact NFL coaches possibly being in the candidate pool?
Well, sure. First, in terms of navigating, one of the things that's most important for me to do is not add to misinformation. So I will not be making any kind of comments or responses to specific candidates or specific rumors. As I told our team when I met with them earlier today, unless they've heard it from me directly, they shall and should not believe it. So we will respect the integrity of the process. I know that's difficult for all of you all as you have your job to do, which I certainly respect, even those who greet me in the parking garage early in the morning when I arrive at work. So I respect your desire to ask those questions very much. But my responsibility is to conduct the process as efficiently and as effectively as possible. And for our student-athletes who are in a time of uncertainty, both our current student-athletes and prospective student-athletes, I owe them everything I have in that regard.
The NFL pool, though, does that make it tighter with the not even a specific name, but just as NFL candidates in general make it tough with the December 20th?
I think I've answered the question as best I can answer it for you.
This next candidate would be the fifth coach in 11 seasons. The perception of instability, will that be a challenge of persuading the coach to take this position?
I believe that the opportunities at the University of Tennessee are extraordinary. And there's so many things about the fundamental fabric of our program and our university. This is the most beautiful city in our conference. This is a special and vibrant place. We've got a great university. We have an outstanding chancellor, Chancellor Davenport, who's done a super job of connecting with our students and faculty. This is a wonderful opportunity. You know, if you look out in the realm of college athletics, certainly the kind of turnover we've had that you mentioned is not optimal. But at the same time, with a couple exceptions, the old days of having somebody for 15 or 20 or 30 years just don't really exist anymore. So transition is part of our enterprise, and preparedness for transition is part of my responsibility.
Finish up with Grant.
John, at what point was this decision made? Or did you have to make this decision? Was it last night or was it early this morning?
Late last night, it was evident that this was probably the direction we needed to go for the best of all concerns. We have two games left to play. We want our student athletes to have the best possible chance for success. We want Coach Jones and his family to be treated with the dignity and respect that they deserve. We want to be able to focus, from my perspective, on search going forward. So none of us want to be in this position. But we are in this position, and now we move forward.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.